clearly with elections in Rajasthan this year and general elections next year, the issue of migrant Bangladeshis is not likely to die down soon.
Moving on, one army jawan was killed in firing in the line of control a day before foreign secretaries of India and Pakistan meet in Islamabad.
The increasing instances of border firing and alleged ceasefire violations are a cause of concern for the Indian army.
Chief Minister Ghulam Nabi Azad is saying peace and terror can't go side by side.
So the question is, will the spurt in violence put a question mark on the five-year-old ceasefire?
Firing yet again on the LoC, the second in less than 15 days. This time in the Poonch sector, one jawan was killed.
Today morning at around 8 a.m., the Pakistanis resorted to small arms firing, as well as they fired RPGs and UBGL grenades on our deep post. We have lost a jawan, Nayak Jayeshwar, from Gorkha Rifles.
Last week there was heavy firing from across the border in the Tangdar sector. The first case of ceasefire violation in 3 years. The Prime Minister calls it worrisome. Earlier this month there was an infiltration attempt in Samba, followed by a terror strike in the same sector. Some see the spurt in violence as an attempt by the Pakistani army to embarrass the government there. The situation somewhat similar to 1999. On Tuesday, foreign secretaries of India and Pakistan meet in Islamabad, the first after a coalition government was installed there. This will be followed by ministerial level talks. India and Pakistan are holding higher level talks after new political dispensation came to power in Pakistan. India has made it clear that way forward is an end to violence, but cases of ceasefire violations and infiltration attempts will be a cause of concern for the Indian side. In Jammu, Zafar Iqbal for NDTV.